I really messed up my O-levels, as was then. So I'm Stephen Turnock, I'm an academic at the University of Southampton. I've been here a while. And the project I'm involved in, I'm a naval architect now, is around ship design, and we're looking to design and size the number of ships and how they perform to transport liquid carbon dioxide, potentially produced from generating blue hydrogen, and taking it to a geological storage where it's out of the atmosphere and it's going to therefore be helping and deal with greenhouse gases by reducing those in the atmosphere. I think people always say about engineers that you must like solving problems, and I really do. I think the challenge of having a finite resource and a finite time and having to come and find an answer. If anyone's seen Apollo 13, you'll know exactly what I mean. And I think that's one of an inspirational film that I'd definitely recommend. And if you like that and you get that idea of having to solve that problem using the resources around you, that's why you should be an engineer. I went to a school visit to the Railway Research Centre in Derby, where we were doing wind tunnel tests of the then new sort of high-speed train designs. I just thought that was super cool and I wanted to do something like that. That was a long time ago. And then progressively since then, I've kind of refined the things I'm interested in, but actually I'm still doing wind tunnel tests and towing tank experiments and interested in fluid flow around things like ships, which not too dissimilar to flow around a railway engine. For me, I was terrible at writing. I was really, really bad. And I don't know how I managed to scrape through with the English qualification at 16, but I did. And I had to work really hard in my early 20s when I was writing up my PhD and writing papers. Now I spend a lot of my time writing emails, writing papers, doing things, and it comes much more naturally to me, but I had to really work at that. And in fact, I chose my A-levels to avoid anything that remotely looked like an essay because of that. But yeah, I think everyone has things they're good at and things they're not so good at. You have to work hard at the things you're not so good at. So the towing tank at Southampton is a long, narrow tank of water, and we take a scale model of a ship and we tow it and we measure the force on the scale model of the ship. And that allows us to decide how large a propeller, how large an engine, or how much power needs to be installed in the vessel. So it's a critical part of the ship design process. So a Southampton tank is the first one to be built in the UK for about 50 years. And it's going to be fundamental to our research over the next few decades. And, you know, some of the work that we do in IDRIC will be allied with that kind of studies on ship form and ship design that we're doing. Oh yeah, I've got a question from one of the students. Do you have any goals regarding your specific area of expertise, anything you are hoping to discover or solve? My fundamental interest on propellers, rudders, and how you design a ship. At the moment, I think I'm most interested in is, I think if we're going to go to using electric power in ships, I think we can reimagine how the stern end of a ship is arranged to increase the overall efficiency of the ship. And I think that probably means we'll be looking at designing ships with multiple propellers and a different approach to what happens to the shape of a hull towards the end. A few percent improvement in efficiency on a ship will make a massive amount of difference over the sort of 100,000 large ships there are in the world if we redesign them better for the future. So I think at the moment, the climate change is the number one thing that we have to deal with, and I personally fully committed to that, and I think IDRIC is going to be an important part of the jigsaw. I mean, engineers will be the people who find the technology solutions that make a difference, as long as the economics and the politics can be sort of accept the fact that people have to change what they do in their lives, that some things are going to cost more, that we have to change how we behave. And if we don't, we will suffer extreme consequences. So that's really important that we make that progress now.